Yo, what's up guys, Karan Plays here and welcome back to the 12th episode of the Chelsea Career Mode series. And you guys voted for your player of the episode, Christian Pulisic, with 94% of the votes after scoring the perfect hat-trick, gets this 84 rated card. Before getting into our match against Brighton, we've got to talk about Willian here. I saw a lot of mixed reactions about Willian, some telling me to sell him, some telling me to use him in a player swap deal. And well, the thing is I cannot sell him right now, he has less than 6 months left on his contract. So for that, I'll have to renew his contract and then try to sell him, which I think is pretty pointless. And as far as y'all are concerned that bringing in Adama Traore might reduce the chances of Hudson-Odoi and Pulisic, I can assure you guys that will not happen. Because well, with the addition of Adama Traore, we'll only have 3 wingers. And well, we are still in 3 competitions. The Premier League, the Champions League and the FA Cup. So that will actually not even be enough. But having 3 great choices in the team will only benefit our side. Oh man, this is really, really bad for us. Jorginho is unhappy with his involvement in the club and he has given us an ultimatum, which we will get into shortly. But I guess this was coming because, well, this has been building up since the start of the series. I think I have to back up a bit and explain some things here. As you guys can see here, both Jorginho and Kovacic just aren't happy with the number of games that they are getting. And well, Jorginho has had enough. He's threatening to leave, guys, and he's given us an ultimatum here. And here it is guys, Jorginho has approached me directly, which I do respect. He feels he's in his prime and is in good form and he cannot afford to lose any game time. He wants to play week in, week out, and well, he's given me an ultimatum here. It's either him or Kovacic according to him, and well, I don't appreciate that, man. I think that's a little too forward from him. And well, now I don't think it'll be great for keeping both of them in the club because that will not be good for our morale. So we'll have to get this sorted out ASAP. For now, I'll tell him to keep his head in the game. Let's take a look at both of these players here. Just look at them, man. Both of their performances are great. Team performance, great. Contract, they're happy with it. But playtime, both of them have an issue with the playtime here. And now that we have to take a decision about their futures, let's go ahead and take a look at their stats. What have they done for the team here? Okay, Jorginho has been involved in 6 goals and has an average rating of 7.3 every single match. Whereas Kovacic here has been involved in 2 goals and has an average rating of 7. So this decision is really, really tough, man. I don't know, who do we go with? Both of them have been excellent for our team. I'm gonna leave this up to y'all because I'm pretty sure that I cannot keep both of them in the side now happy. Because well, now that Jorginho has even called out Mateo Kovacic, it'll be detrimental for the team's morale to keep both of them in the side. I'm gonna put a poll up here right now. Jorginho or Kovacic? You guys decide. And with that said, let's get into the first match of this episode. And for our trip to the Amex Stadium, I'm going with my first choice 11 here because we have a cup game, an FA Cup match coming right after this one. And I'm going to be simming that one, so I'm going to be using my second team. So for this one, we'll be using our first team with just the one change. Zuma has come in for Antonio Rudiger. And the rest of the lineup goes like this. Timo Werner up top, Pulisic, Ziyech and Hudson-Odoi are attacking midfielders. Kante and Jorginho in the CDM roles. Emerson, Zuma, Skriniar, Reece James, our defensive line, and Kepa in goal. And here we go, our lads step onto the pitch. Our team's morale is a bit unknown right now. The form that we are in indicated that our team was gelling well, but with the dressing room undress caused by Jorginho and Kovacic, I'm not too sure how this game is gonna go. Hopefully our players don't forget that they are playing for the club, they are playing for the badge, and do not disappoint us and get the 3 points here. Hakim Ziyech plays it to Jorginho, who's desperate to prove that he just doesn't talk the talk, but he can also walk the talk, and that's a brilliant ball for Hudson-Odoi. And Hudson-Odoi makes it 1-0 in the starting minutes of this game. Jorginho with another assist. Man, this decision is going to be really, really tough for us. Jorginho with a fantastic through ball to find Hudson-Odoi there. He absolutely split the defense, and Hudson-Odoi, continuing his hot form, gets us a goal in the early stages of this match. The perfect start to this game, and now we've taken the lead at the Amex Stadium. Mope to Arumui, Arumui back to Neil Mope, Mope with a fantastic chance here, and they've split open our defense, and Neil Mope 1v1 against Kepa doesn't miss. Fantastic work from Brighton, then the 1-2 between Mope and Mui, absolutely deadly, and Neil Mope gets them back into this game. Fantastic dribbling from Hakim Ziyech. Finds Christian Pulisic, we can make it 2-1 straight from kickoff here. Christian Pulisic, unfortunately, couldn't keep the shot on target. And that's it for the first half here, guys. 1-1, we started off pretty well, but towards the end of the half, we didn't keep enough pressure. And well, that's cost us 1 goal. Timo Werner here kicks things off for the second half. Reece James's clearance is awful here. Marsh on the ball, but Skriniar sniffs the danger out. Aaron Mooney finds Davy Proper. Davy Proper on the ball now, and he has actually scored here. Kepa didn't even move. What has happened to our side, man? And Proper is shushing us. This is just toxic and awful behavior from them. That was a great ball from Mui to find Davy Proper there. And Zuma tried to clear it off the line. But what happened to Kepa there? What has happened to our team here? 67 minutes have been played. And Ziyech, well, he hasn't done much in this half. So I'm going to bring Mason Mount on for him. And well, Timo Werner is not having a good game here too. He's also not scored, I don't remember, from the past 2 or 3 games. So I'm bringing Tammy Abraham on for him. Oh my god, they've split our defense apart yet again. March plays it to Mope, and Mope has scored another one. 3-1 down against Brighton. I guess the speculation in Jorginho and Kovacic's future has really, really affected our team here. What has happened to our side, man? They've absolutely crumbled. Neil Mope with an easy finish. Kepa concedes for the first time, I believe, 3 goals in a single match. Guys, things aren't working out well for us here, so I'm going to bring Jorginho off for Ross Barkley. I've changed the formation to a 4-3-3, and hopefully, guys, hopefully we can at least get a draw here. Mason Mount has intercepted their pass here. Kante looking for Abraham to make a run. Come on, Abraham. Please, bro, make a run here. Finally, we've got the ball with Abraham. In a dangerous position, Abraham is brought down. Unfortunately, though, it is outside the box, so we do get a free kick in a really, really dangerous position. And as we don't have Hakim Ziyech here, we're going to take this one with Mason Mount. Mason Mount with the free kick, and it's nowhere near the target, man. Davy Proper on the ball now. They've absolutely dominated us in this game. Still Proper now. Whips the ball in, but Emerson with a fantastic interception, and we might have a chance on the counter here. Christian Pulisic. Lewis Dunk does brilliantly there to marshal the ball out of play. Barkley finds Kante. Now Hudson-Odoi. Great turn from Hudson-Odoi to skip past their left back. Hudson-Odoi too can't do anything here though. And that's it for this game, guys. 3-1, what an awful, awful display against Brighton over Albion. And guys, this just shows us there is some discontent in our team here. Our players just weren't their usual self out there on the pitch today. You've got to get the situation between Jorginho and Kovacic sorted out ASAP. We've heard back from Wolves and they've given us a counter offer here. 11.7 million plus William and a 15% sell-on clause. That is still too much, man. I'll try to get it down to 10 million and well, I'll even try to get the sell-on clause down to say 10%. Okay, so let's edit the sell-on clause here. Let's make it 10% and transfer fee, let's get it down to 10 million. Perfect. Finally, after going back and forth continuously, we have finally agreed on a deal for Adama Traore. And now all that's left is to negotiate the contract with Adama Traore. Oh wow, he wants a sporadic role. Well, that's perfect, man. As long as he doesn't cry for playing time and well, adjust with Hudson-Odoi and Pulisic, I'm perfectly happy. He wants a 3-year deal. I don't want a 3-year deal. I want him to be at the club for as long as possible. So I'm going to offer him a 5-year deal. He still wants a 3-year deal. Come on, man. Let's try and get a 4-year deal at least, because Adama Traore is one for the future. And well, he's gone ahead and accepted this one. He doesn't want a release clause. I'm perfectly fine with that. And now time for his wages. I know he's earning around 70k per week at Wolves, so I'm going to offer him 80k and a signing bonus of say 300k. Hopefully he's happy with the contract we've offered him. And he's actually delighted with the contract that we've offered him. Adama Traore is now a Chelsea player. Unfortunately though, he's injured right now. But thankfully, that's just for 3 weeks. And once he's back, I'm pretty sure he's gonna obliterate fullbacks. Another interesting comment that I read was to, you know, change Hakim Ziyech's number to number 10. And well, he's our most creative player. So why not? Let's go ahead and do that. Hakim Ziyech is now our number 10. Y'all let me know what number should we give Adama Traore. And well, 14 isn't a bad number either. But still, if y'all want me to change his kit number, do let me know down in the comment section below. And up next, we've got the third round of the FA Cup. Chelsea versus Accrington Stanley. We are playing this one at home. And well, it's the FA Cup against a team that's not in the Premier League. So we're going to go ahead and sim this one. I'm using my second team, but I've made a few changes here. I did not want to start either one of Jorginho or Kovacic. So I've benched both of them for this one. Kovacic, who was usually starting for our second team, is now on the bench, and Billy Gilmore replaces him for today's match. I've gone with the 4-1-2-1-2 here because I want Werner to also get back into roles and Abraham to also get a few goals here. And our lineup goes like this. Timo Werner and Tammy Abraham up top. Mason Mount our cam. Barkley and Gilmore are central midfielders. Loftus-Cheek playing for the first time alone in that CDM role. Goolam, Zuma, Tomori and Rafael make up our defence. And Willy Caballero in goal. And another 2-1 win. I guess 2-1 has been our most popular result in this series here. Tammy Abraham and Timo Werner getting the goals for us. So that's brilliant to see that our strikers are getting back into the goals here. So we just about managed to edge past Accrington Stanley in the FA Cup. So we are going on to the fourth round. And now let's move on to our next Premier League game. Okay, Adama Traore is back from injury. But the chances of him aggravating it are still high. So I'm not going to start him for the next match. I might just bring him on as a super sub. So that he can get a few minutes under his belt. And you know, the Chelsea fans can get a glimpse of what he can do. And I'm pretty sure they're eager to see their new signing on the pitch. And here's how the Premier League table looks like before heading to the game against Burnley. Well, that L against Brighton has cost us here. We are now 3 points behind the top four. And for the match at the Stamford Bridge, I'm going with my first choice 11. The only change I've made in this side is that I've brought Jorginho off for Loftus-Cheek. I don't want any player who's not giving his 100%, who has his mind somewhere else on the pitch. We need the 3 points here. We cannot afford any distractions. So here's how the team looks like for the game against Burnley. Timo Werner up top, Pulisic, Ziyech and Hudson-Odoi are attacking midfielders. Kante and Loftus-Cheek are CDMs. Reece James, Skriniar, Rudiger and Emerson in defence. And Kepa Arrizabalaga in goal. And here we have it, Chelsea versus Burnley at the Stamford Bridge. We are looking to bounce back after that disappointing result against Brighton. Our fans expect nothing less than the 3 points here. We've got Adama Traore on the bench who might just come on to make his debut. Loftus-Cheek getting a rare opportunity in the Premier League, so hopefully he can put in a great performance and show us why we should be starting him in more and more games. And without further ado, let's kick things off at the Stamford Bridge. Skriniar wins the ball here. Reece James plays it to Hudson-Odoi, who plays it to Loftus-Cheek now. Loftus-Cheek finds N'Golo Kante. Kante towards Timo Werner. We might have a chance here. Timo Werner almost brought down in the box. Unfortunately, after that, he couldn't get the shot off. Hakim Ziyech, our new number 10 on the ball now, plays it to Hudson-Odoi. Hudson-Odoi in a fantastic position here. Finesses it and finds the back of the net for the second consecutive game here. Callum Hudson-Odoi is in top form right now. Brilliant work from our new number 10. Hakim Ziyech with a fantastic turn and a great ball towards Hudson-Odoi. And Hudson-Odoi with a brilliant, brilliant finesse shot, learning from Timo Werner, gets us into the lead yet again. Hudson-Odoi, another interception from him. Skips past McNeil's challenge. Still Hudson-Odoi on the ball. Oh, he's just abusing his pace right now. Brilliant work from him. Plays it to Ziyech. Ziyech looking for Loftus-Cheek, but the pass wasn't good enough. Oh, Rodriguez has just done Skriniar there, but Rudiger recovers well. Antonio Candreva looking for Diallo here. Diallo up against Skriniar. Skriniar does fantastically to recover the ball and the possession. McNeil on the ball, whips this one in. What has happened to Kepa here? That was way off target. What was he even trying to do? And some transfer news from other clubs here. Davinson Sanchez has transferred from Spurs to Inter Milan. Kepa finding Hakim Ziyech. Still Ziyech on the ball, but the ref blows his whistle. Half time, 1-0, we are in the lead here. Yet another encouraging start from our side. Hopefully we can continue the same in the second half and get the win here. Diallo on the ball now. Emerson, brilliant interception from him. Finds Loftus-Cheek. Loftus-Cheek towards Christian Pulisic. Great movement from our side. Werner finding Hakim Ziyech. Hakim Ziyech towards Hudson-Odoi. Hudson-Odoi against the left back. Does brilliantly here. He has a lot of space and a lot of support too. Looking for Christian Pulisic. But man, that was the wrong choice there. He could have gone for goal himself. Or you know, found Timo Werner. But he chose the most complicated pass and couldn't pull it off. Jay Rodriguez plays it to Peters. Hudson-Odoi with a fantastic interception. Timo Werner has made a run here. Hudson-Odoi finds him with a brilliant pass. Timo Werner, man, what an awful touch there. 73 minutes played with around 15 minutes left. Let's bring on Adama Traore for Hudson-Odoi. Hudson-Odoi has done his job here. Reece James plays it to Adama Traore. Traore with his first touch here. Man, he's rapid. Adama Traore gunning down that right wing role. Still Adama Traore on the ball. Come on, we might just be able to make it 2-0 here. Adama Traore towards Pulisic. Unfortunately, at the very last moment, Nick Pope gets a great touch and the ball is cleared. Okay, they have a chance on the counter here. Kandreva plays it to Rodriguez. Skriniar has absolutely mauled Rodriguez there. Hopefully, he doesn't get a card here. And he doesn't. But that, well, I'm calling it a tactical foul. Antonio Candreva from the free kick. And instead of hitting the target, he's gone ahead and hit one of the fans here. Rudiger. Kante. Oh, that's a fantastic ball from Pulisic. Pulisic up against Seamus Coleman. Brilliant skill moves from Pulisic. Goes for the finish shot. Nick Pope making yet another save for them. Loftus-Cheek finds Adama Traore. One last chance for him to get something on his debut here. Adama Traore whips another ball in, but Peters with the block here. And that's it for this game, guys. 1-0 win against Burnley. I feel we did deserve more here, but the 3 points and the clean sheet, I'll take it, man. And now we've got some mixed reactions from Kovacic and Jorginho. And well, guys, this just isn't healthy for our side. We've got to get rid of one of them here. Unfortunately, it has come down to this, but no player is bigger than the club, so we've got to get rid of one of these players. Y'all have to vote, guys. Kovacic or Jorginho, who is to stay and who is to leave? Okay, we've received an offer for Christian Pulisic from 40 million from Arsenal. 40 million isn't a small amount, and well, Christian Pulisic, I know he's been amazing for us, but for 40, or maybe, you know, if we negotiate for 45 million, well, it's a lucrative deal, guys. But for now, I'm gonna stall this one. I'm gonna wait for your inputs and suggestions down in the comment section below. Okay, well, I'd said in the last episode that I'm looking for a backup goalkeeper, and well, y'all gave me a variety of options. Andre Lunin, unfortunately though, we can't sign him here because he's on loan at Real Oviedo right now. Same thing goes for Lafont, he's on loan at Nantes right now. So it's between Alexander Nubil and Bijlo. Nubil has just 6 months remaining on his contract, so we can actually, you know, go ahead and sign him on a pre-contract agreement. That might be key here, but if we can sign Bijlo on a loan deal for now, I'll actually go ahead with that. Let's see, if they accept for a loan deal, I'll go ahead with Bijlo, but if he doesn't, let's go ahead and sign Nubil. Okay, Feyenoord aren't interested in loaning him out. So you know what, guys, for our first pre-contract deal, let's approach Alexander Nubil and, you know, try and sign him and get him in the summer. Okay, so first things first, for Nubil, let's try with the sporadic role. I'm not sure whether he'll accept that, but let's try that. Oh, perfect. He's happy with that. Now, the length of the contract, you guys know, I want to keep players for as long as possible. So let's go ahead with a 5-year contract. He wants a 3-year deal. I'm not happy with that. Let's take a 4-year contract. But if he doesn't accept that, we'll go with a 3-year deal. Perfect. He's accepted a 4-year contract. That works for me too. No release clause. That's perfect. He wants 44.5k per week and a signing bonus of 390,000. And y'all know, man, I've over a million in the wage budget, so I don't want any more discontent in our team. So I'll just go ahead and accept this offer. And here we have it, guys. We've signed Alexander Nubil on a free from Schalke. He'll be joining us at the start of next season. So well, our goalkeeping role for the next few seasons is completely sorted. And well, another player that I would like to talk about, Philippe Coutinho. Honestly, I'm not too keen on signing him right now because we do have Ziyech in that cam role. We've got Mason Mount on the bench, we've got Ross Barkley on the bench. And I don't want to push Ziyech out wide to a winger role because we've just added another winger to our side. So yeah, Philippe Coutinho in this January transfer window, not happening, guys. And before wrapping up this episode, let's take a look at the Premier League table. We are 3 points behind Manchester City. And honestly, we've struggled to score goals. So I was thinking we might, you know, bring in a striker. Tammy Abraham, well, he's not impressed me at all. Timo Werner, I think we are over dependent on him at that striker role. So guys, I know I initially said that I'm not looking to sell Tammy Abraham, well, at least until the next summer. But seeing that we do need to pick up our goal difference if we do want to stand a chance to, you know, get into the top four, bringing in a new striker and, you know, letting go of Tammy Abraham could be the way forward for this club. And for the player of the episode, guys, well, we had a disappointing episode. The only bright light was Callum Hudson-Odoi, so I'm not even going to put up a poll this time. Callum Hudson-Odoi will get a player of the episode card in the next episode. And that's it for today's episode, guys. If you all enjoyed this one, do leave a like. Do not forget to leave your suggestions down in the comment section below. Share and subscribe, and do not forget to turn on the notification bell so you all know whenever I upload the next episode.